I never even killed a man. I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Hi, Internet. We're playing Talos Principle.
Yes, and I have the photos to prove it.
Yes, and last time we became a person.
We did. We're special and unique in every way.
You have solved many of the mysteries of this land. The road before you is still long and many gates remain closed.
God damn it.
But take comfort in your accomplishment and in your creator's pride.
You jumped through hoops. Pat on the back.
Yeah, really though. Attaboy, now do it some more. Whatever's going on here, I'm sure it has something to do with the tower. Everything is telling us not to go there, but everything indicates that we must. Except the Osiris stories. Unless you're wrong and Elohim's right, or you're both wrong. Or there is no right, dog. I think you've been taking the thing in this archive too seriously. Sheep. Wait, I thought sheep terminated.
No, that was at.
At, that's right.
At turned into dog.
At's,
right,
at's
right,
get
right.
turned into dog and Samsara's gone.
Samsara
gets
turned
Osiris.
Into Samsara.
Oh.
Tell me of the fearsome demons of the Duat, the dying man said to the wise scribe. Though their terrible forms are loathsome to behold, they are not evil, for they are the servants of the gods. Truly, they are the blessed doorkeepers and guardians of the holy paths. Their charge is to judge whether we are worthy to pass the gates that lead to Aeru. I don't know. And so they challenge us with riddles or in combat. Is this true of all the beings that live in the Duat? Some say that is not so, that there are ancient gods whose names have been forgotten, and spirits of darkness whose name none have ever known, and that these must be avoided at all costs. But others say that these too serve a greater purpose in ways that Osiris has not revealed to us. And what of the hidden paths that are taken by blank when the blank? Coming soon. From Rob McLean, Institute for Applied Nomadics, to Mom,
Applied
subject,
Nomadics.
Coming soon, your son,
in
3D. Hi, Mom. I promise I'll be home soon. Maybe a couple of weeks? I know. But what we're doing here is important, and the team needs my help. I'm not going to wait until it's too late, I promise, but there's so much we have to set up, so much that has to work for a very, very long time. Besides, I've always wanted to work on one of these supercomputers, and believe me, EL is pretty much the best there is. And the team, Mom, it's like I'm working with rock stars and mad geniuses, except nobody's heard of them outside of science journals, of course. But Dad would be totally geeking out if he knew. Maybe I can tell him about it soon, huh? Love, Rob. That's dark.
Yeah.
Log 24 alive. What is the point of being alive? I know, it's an old question and not one that's easy to answer. But I mean, if you're reading this, you are alive. And someday you will stop being alive. Both of these facts are incontrovertible. So what about it then? Don't you wonder? Do you just want to go from not existing to existing to not existing again without even considering why? You, right now, as you sit there reading this, why do you exist? What is the purpose of your life? Do you have one? Should you have one? Is it better to have a purpose or not? When you approach death, will you feel that your life had meaning? If so, why? If not, why not? What defines whether a life was good or not? It may seem abstract right now, but that moment just before death will come. It is inevitable. If you don't ask yourselves these questions, how will you face that moment?
It's true.
It's inevitable.
I have no friends.
You gonna live forever? Light
also,
up the sky like a flame?
Also, on the note of them being video game profiles, Sheep said that everything's telling us not to go to the tower, but therefore it seems like we should go to the tower.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Why would
these things exist if not to use them?
Whoops.
Right. So that's, yeah, similarly, or the old RPG maxim of if something tells you to go somewhere, you must immediately go there. If somebody
mm-hmm.
tells you not to go somewhere, you must immediately go there.
Mm-hmm. Also, why did we get a brief Elohim statement when you walk away?
When you get near the border of the world, it informs you
right,
that.
Oh, right.
It gives
that's
you
right.
the one quote, yeah. And
that's right.
Also, no Easter eggs in the moon this time.
Oh, I was just about to ask.
It wouldn't do the same thing twice. Puzzle broke.
Uh-oh. Can we get a tool out of here, then?
Hmm? Nah.
No.
Huh.
It's just unloaded.
Huh.
Star. We're gonna be partway through it, and Elohim will be like, I restole thee! And then we'll be in the middle of a puzzle, be like, what the fuck?
No, apparently not. Interesting.
Yeah.
There's a crack in the wall. Slightly elevated sigil. We got fans, we got blocks, we got lasers.
We got everything. Well, except time puzzles.
I was going to say except time puzzles. Except so the not recording everything. Thing,
yeah.
Alright, so we gotta grab that fan, I'm guessing, and point it there. Yeah, that makes sense.
Gotta get this box, because remember, we can combine fans with boxes to make floating platforms.
Yep.
Adventure
get
game
that,
logic.
Get that.
And those. Then I fucked this, but there yep. we go.
That's cool. That'll do. Alright, so we gotta put that over on the fan. Yeah, yeah, okay. So that goes on a fan. Take that and put it on top.
Except then we need something to connect the beam because there's a wall in the way.
Alright, but good thing we have two of them.
Yes.
So use that. Take it there.
And I got the timing off a little bit.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah, you have a very small window to do this.
Mm-hmm. Goes. Wait, now I'm confused.
Yeah,
so
what
I'm
are
trying,
you trying
to do? So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to ride the box up.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Yes.
Look at that.
Now you understand my madness. I realize now the way you're probably supposed to solve this puzzle.
Yeah. You're supposed to go up here and use the box to slightly elevate. Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Over the wall, which is why I think it's the slightly
elevated sigil. Yeah. Right, I just immediately got like, oh, I can jump on this box.
Yeah. That wasn't exactly the idea.
So, doesn't that mean if you went back up there, you can bring that out of the course?
Indeed. Mm-hmm. Exactly right.
All right. Let's grab that, and let's jump down.
Now, one of the things is, when you bring things out of the puzzle, that means you have to avoid having the puzzles reset.
Right.
Because it resets the entire map. And, oh yeah, and also I do this because I am supposed to do something else with that before I do that.
Oh, okay.
I wasn't supposed to bring it out yet, I was supposed to leave it on the wall.
Whoops. So we gotta reset it all.
Yep, my bad.
Alright. We get a thing, hey, I wonder what this thing does.
Oh
it's
that, yep, yeah, the mysteries, mysteries upon mysteries.
Chupa-chups. Probably could have cut this, but whatever!
Nope. The public deserves to know.
The public deserves to know that you're just as bad at video games as I am.
We could take some, I will say I'm not great at video games, but I will say that the other part has yet to be proven.
I'm pretty bad.
Mostly
because
I have not played All of Our Friends Are Dead and racked up like 150 plus deaths. You know, after that game went out, one of the people said, like, after watching this, I downloaded this game and I only died 60 times.
It was difficult. It required precise timing, which I'm bad at. Alright, so
that's one part of a multi-part thing. Most of the parts are going to come out of this.
Yeah. Alley of the Pressure Plates.
Yeah,
okay.
So this is one of the ones. This is a recording puzzle that requires us to use, like, five things.
Sweet. I'm in.
Yeah.
Hype.
Get hype. Get hype on
pretty
Skype.
I mean...
Smoke pipe.
Yes.
Don't gripe.
Right tribe.
No, I don't. I don't want to do any of these things. They all sound bad.
So you do want to gripe?
Yeah, I'm doing it right now. I'm griping at this moment. I'm griping so hard, you don't even know.
Stop griping.
I can't. It's in my blood. I was born to gripe.
Click type.
So this sure is a force field.
Yep. Yeah, that was interesting.
Yep. That was the humming sound it made.
Meow. Also meow.
Calling
attention. Calling attention to the cat.
That's what we do in moments of weakness.
Oh, why, cat? He gets so ornery during this time between when it starts to get dark and when it fully gets dark, because he doesn't want to go outside until it's completely dark. But he starts getting loud and obnoxious.
I want to go out, but I don't. It's not right. I want to go out, but it's not right yet.
But I want it to
be
right.
I'll bring him up on my lap, and that'll sate him for a bit. He'll let me pet him, but then he'll get antsy and jump down and go somewhere else briefly, and then keep meowing at me. It's a great cycle.
It's a vicious cycle.
It's the circle of life, and it moves a song.
I remember one of the first movies I saw in Spanish during one of my foreign language classes was The Lion King.
Nice.
And I remember my favorite thing is, like, they really did not try at all to make the circle, to make the words for the circle of life, like, fit the meter. Like, it's en el ciclo de vivan.
Nice.
And then I realized I did the bad thing. Because I can't hit this with the lasers. So I have to put the laser beam thing. So I have to put the laser beam thing as the first one, so that I can connect the beam and bend it around the corner, and also put it on the pressure plate. I got a lot of balls in the air here, man.
I mean, kind of literally.
And prior to what many people think, I am not an ace ball handler.
Now, when you make the duplicates of stuff by interacting with the recording, can you make them interact with, like, the?
No, the recording happens independently of the you.
Right.
You can stack a box on top of itself. The only thing you can't do is mess with your record itself. Your record itself will just run through things.
Right.
Yeah, because
I would look at
the you wasn't there when you were.
Because yeah. I would look at this puzzle and be like, can I connect those things and put two boxes on?
So the thing is, you also need enough objects to then activate all the switches.
Yeah, I suppose that's true.
So that's the thing. So that's why then our good friend Fred needs to sit here for a little bit and think about what he did.
Damn it, Fred.
Fred, why you gotta be so Fred?
Why do you keep making Mr. Slate so angry?
All you gotta do, Fred, is just exactly what you're fucking up. Fred wanted to look at some force fields too.
Yep. He's an ace force field watcher.
He's a force fieldman.
He watched force fields back in Nam.
Alright, now we're leaving Fred behind.
Yep, goodbye, Fred. Also, just in case we need another way out, there's a ladder.
I guess. That's weird. Alright.
So, yeah. Alright, so we actually can't take things out of that puzzle. It's a different puzzle. I thought that was one with stairs, but it's not.
Okay. I have been running this gauntlet for generations, trying to find the right answers. I'm fast coming to the conclusion that there are none.
So I know you were yawning while you were saying that, but you didn't quite yawn, and so the resulting voice. Have you ever watched Monty Python's Flying Circus?
Yes.
There's the guy with the bandana tied around his head. Uh-huh. That just keeps yelling everything.
pretty much.
Anesthetic!
Alright. Fred's back.
Fred's back with a brand new jam.
Fred's dead, baby. Fred's dead.
So yeah, this is our multi-track jamming that we got from the last time.
Sweet. God damn it, you just fucking... I hate you.
I am memes and they are me.
you are just a pure meme.
I am the purest meme.
a thoroughbred meme.
So, just to talk about other video games while we're talking over this video game, I recently watched the ending of Metal Gear Solid 2 again, and
oh my God.
Somebody actually explained it to me, and it made sense.
Metal Gear Solid 2 is the story of a ghost trying to have a conversation with his brothers.
So one of the things I didn't know is that Metal Gear Solid 1, 2, and 3 are all about different principles that make a person based on each of the core letters of MG and of Metal Gear Solid. So the first one is about genes, the second one is about memes, and the third one is about scenes.
But I mean, the literal plot of Metal Gear Solid 2 is a ghost wanting to have a conversation with his two brothers. Like, I'm not even joking. Like, the ghost of Liquid arranges everything using Ocelot to...
Well, no, because the Patriots arrange everything there. Also, major spoilers for anyone who hasn't played Metal Gear Solid 2.
No, because the idea is that the Patriot... You realize the Patriots are arranging everything, but then you realize that Liquid has... Liquid has arranged it so that the Patriots would arrange it in there so that Snake would be there.
But the other thing is that Liquid then goes after the Patriots based on the knowledge that Ocelot has, but the Patriots saw through that and gave Ocelot bad knowledge so that Liquid's going after nothing.
I know, it's so good. But the whole reason that Liquid wanted Solidus and Snake there is so that he could talk with them.
Yeah.
Like, and you go the entire game. Metal Gear Solid 2 has my favorite line in the bomb disposal expert going, "I killed my soul. I detonated my legacy." It's pretty good.
I don't remember him saying that. I just watched that.
It's in one of the conversations you have with him.
Yeah, I know that he's...
I killed my soul.
I also like that after he reveals that, like, he covered up having an injury so that nobody would blame... Everybody would feel sorry for him and no one would blame him for the disaster that happened. Ryan then says, he was a hero. He died a good man. It's like, no, he died a liar and a coward.
Yeah, he was a terrible person in the end.
And also,
I killed my soul.
Come on, figure it out. Figure it out, me.
God.
Nope, you're not going to figure it out this run, are you? Nope.
Nope. You don't get it.
Nope. Like, why, like, man, this is really easy. Why don't I just jam this? Oh, right, because it's intended to use two jammers.
Yep. God damn it.
So apparently the two puzzle types I can't remember are both, are really easy puzzles and also really long puzzles.
Yeah. Alright, so we got that. Get you standing on that.
Yep.
Have you come over here?
Just making sure I have enough time.
Yep, and now have you jammed that?
Yep.
And we're good. Alright, take the jammer.
But yeah, I was, the game, the thing I was watching was actually Giant Bomb playing through it.
Mm-hmm.
And Dan Reichard was playing through with Drew Scanlon. I remember, I think my favorite line from that was Drew just like having gone through it being like frustrated and confused, and Dan said, like, "Don't feel bad. I spent the entirety of my adult life understanding this game."
Yeah, it really, I mean, that's kind of, I mean, I am now continuing the conversation about other video games while we play this video
Whatever.
Game.
Whatever, there's apparently not enough for us to discuss here.
I mean, there kind of isn't, like, you're rolling through puzzles and
it's a puzzle game. We could try and talk about some of the documents, but they're all kind of cryptic.
Yeah, I mean, and we'll find out more about them and talk about them as we go.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, Metal Gear is sweet because it's deliberately crafted to be. It's like it's very akin to The Great Gatsby, which was deliberately written to be as chock full of symbols as it possibly could be. Like, that was the author's intention, and it's why, like, college or high school English teachers just cream themselves over it, because they get to point out all of the different ways that this is all symbolic. And that's why it reads really badly, because that's a really bad way to write. But it turns out it's actually a kind of cool way to write a video game. Because you have a lot more...
I think it's also not just that there's also symbols, like Hideo Kojima just does crazy fucking bullshit, like, all the time.
Right, exactly. I mean, but one of the key points of that is that as it's a video game, because it's so symbolic, but you can interact with it, it gives it a lot more impact, and, you know, it matters more rather than just as a novel.
Yeah, I suppose. And also, in The Great Gatsby, like, nobody fights a harrier driven by a vampire.
Well, yeah, I mean, but...
with the president riding shotgun.
I mean, yes. Also, I've said it before, and I'll say it again, but the Metal Gear Solid series reads, is really even better if you imagine it's like somebody writing out all of the things that a role-playing group did.
Yeah.
like, it's really funny that way, and I highly enjoy it.
I can't remember if the... I remember somebody was saying that about, I remember somebody was actually saying that about, like, the prompt for Adventure Time.
Yeah, I mean,
I can't remember if that was confirmed or if people are just saying that Penn Ward based that on his old role-playing group.
Yeah, I mean, I can definitely see it. It has a lot of those elements to it.
I know when my dad saw the show, he really thought it was a show about D&D.
Mm-hmm. All right, get that out of the box. So many boxes.
So many boxes. Get in there.
D&D and the random shit players do to,
Mm-hmm. So all that was just to get another laser beam?
Yeah, because we need two of them, because we need a red laser to open the doorway to the blue laser.
Right, and then we need a blue laser to connect to the blue platform.
Yeah.
Cool.
Really roundabout ways. We gotta make very harsh exchanges here.
Yes. Love it. Yes. Alright, so blue laser.
Yeah.
So blue laser. Yep.
It's like a really long version of Settlers of Catan. I got all this cotton, but what I really need is wheat.
Does anyone want to trade me for some wheat?
Okay, no, I guess I'll just go to the 4-1 island. And just, hey, I can climb on this. Maybe I can use this to get somewhere, because there's this weird fan here. I have no idea how to get to it or what its purpose is, because it just seems to go to nowhere. So that's weird. Maybe, I think that leads to an Easter egg. I'm just not sure what this is. So this is a really... intense
puzzle. Four chambers of flying. All right, I'm in. Let's look at it.
So, all of these pressure plates here, when you hit one of them, it sets up a force field and it turns on the fan.
Okay.
And that's what all of them do. And so, based on that, we have to then somehow come up with a way to connect a laser beam to this connector at the end, with the beam emitter somewhere on the other side. The only way we can move objects is with the fans, because, again, can't climb ladders with an object, and we have to have an object on one of the push pads to make it open.
Right. So, do we need to set up a recording?
No, there's actually no recordings in this. This is all us.
Okay.
So we gotta blow stuff, because you gotta set it on the fan, but because the same button that activates them turns on,
it's gonna... Yeah, so we gotta throw a Throw a box over. Okay.
Too many
we
boxes.
Have too many boxes. Throw a box away.
Yes. Of course, e-book's still relevant, even in,
yes.
Even after the hoax is done.
Yeah, didn't that turn out to be like an ARG or something?
Yeah, for Bear Money Cerns, I want to say it was called.
Hmm. Interesting.
I remember I was gonna try and play it, but it's like a weird full motion browser game, and it's a weird full motion browser game, and it costs like $10.
That's dumb.
Yeah.
Ooh. Okay, we have a box there.
We do have a box there.
Question is, where do we want that box?
That is the question.
Well, the
isn't
only
it?
Place to do it is do this. Yeah. So, well, now we're back where we started.
So we want to put it over there, so it's in the room with all of the.
Yeah, so it's in the room with all the switches, so that we can activate the
right.
Switch.
So now we go up and over. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Yep. You certainly didn't activate any of those switches in there with that.
Yeah, you gotta. It's. I mean, it's designed like that. So, I'm trying to see what else I can throw over here. I think this just gets blown off the plate, yeah.
Yeah, it's not heavy enough to actually get launched.
Yeah. Just gets knocked around.
Yeah, alright.
So now we
put that on that plate. Take that through.
And hey, there's
a jammer. Oh.
Okay, okay.
Ah, so we can have a fan going and then but jam the field.
Yeah.
Right.
Or jam that field. I suppose the jammer probably cannot, yeah.
Yeah, jam that, bring a box through.
Except then we gotta get the connector.
Right, got it, yeah.
This is one of the interesting things that this puzzle is just a massive troll.
Yeah.
Because it has all of these different elements, and then the solution is just take this jammer across and
take
open
the
door.
Jammer.
Yeah, that's funny. That's kind of funny. All right.
Okay,
cool.
But remember, we still have that box left over, and
mm-hmm.
we can detach that fan blade.
Interesting. Whoop.
So we need this,
that.
So we can do this.
There, take that off.
Nope, that's not how you do that.
Put that there. And...
just gotta throw this
to
the other
there.
Side.
Alright.
And wherever the... yep, there's it.
Grab that box.
There's it.
Take that fan. Put the box on there.
That's my fan.
Fan.
Remember,
top,
it's been a long time
off.
Now, but we did activate that fan next
mm-hmm.
to the obelisk. Oh, hey, a neon terminal.
Oh, hey. Boop, boop.
Beep, boop.
Boop.
Beep, boop.
All right. Communications portal. We got an established connection. Attention, administrator, the network connection has been reestablished. Would you like to reconnect to the previous session? Why? Message, are you back? How do I know I can trust
him?
Fantastic. Not answering the question. So there's a grand total of two same people in this world, and we can't find a way to trust each other. How about I tell you what I think? I've been trying to figure out how this place works. Sometimes it seems like there's a purpose to everything, other times not so much. I think we must be plugged into some kind of machine. Making assertions is a hazardous enterprise. What do you have to go on? I think something else is going on. Okay, okay. What do you have to go on?
I don't believe in demons.
What else could possibly explain all this? I don't believe in demons and evil wizards. Being prepared for
something. I think something has gone badly wrong.
Okay. I suppose that would explain a lot. Listen, there's something else. Maybe it can help us. Ever since I got here, I felt like something was wrong. This place plays tricks with you. Can't get your head straight, but I think I know a way to find out the truth. Digging about in some documents, I kept finding references to this password. I think it might be some kind of library master key, but I don't know how to use it. Swear not to go anywhere without me, and I'll tell you. MLAprocess.bat logged into the session. Wait, what is that? You're doing that to my terminal? I don't think this is a good idea. Session terminated.
Oh.
Hippocratic corpus.
On the sacred disease, 400 BCE, men ought to know that from nothing else but the brain come joys, delights, laughter, and sports, and sorrows, griefs, despondency, and lamentations. And by this, in an especial manner, we acquire wisdom and knowledge, and see and hear, and know what are foul and what are fair, and what are bad and what are good, what are sweet and what unsavory. Some we discriminate by habit, and some we perceive by their utility. By this we distinguish objects of relish and disrelish according to the seasons, and the same things do not always please us, and by the same organ we become mad and delirious, and fears and terrors assail us, some by night and some by day, and dreams and untimely wanderings, and cares that are not suitable, and ignorance of present circumstances, destitute and unskillfulness.
Yeah, I don't know what desuetude is.
Destitute, I don't know. So that is some House of Leaves bullshit right there.
Kinda, yeah. Except for 400 BC.
Mm-hmm. The human brain is a machine for coming to conclusions. If it cannot come to conclusions, it is rusty. When we hear of a man too clever to believe, we are hearing of something having almost the character of a contradiction in terms. It's like hearing of a nail that was too good to hold down a carpet, or a bolt that was too strong to keep a door shut. Man can hardly be defined, after the fashion of Carlyle, as an animal who makes tools. Ants and beavers and many other animals make tools, in the sense that they make an apparatus. Man can be defined as an animal that creates dogmas. As he piles doctrine on doctrine and conclusion on conclusion in the formation of some tremendous scheme of philosophy and religion, he is, in the only legitimate sense of which the expression is capable, becoming more and more human. When he drops one doctrine after another in a refined skepticism, when he declines to tie himself to a system, when he says that he has outgrown definitions, when he says that he disbelieves in finality, when, in his own imagination, he sits as God, holding no form of creed but contemplating all, then he is by that very process sinking slowly backwards into the vagueness of the vagrant animals and the unconsciousness of the grass. Trees have no dogmas. Turnips are singularly broad-minded. Bronstein brain. Archive. Bunch of shit. The human brain is a product of the development of matter, at the same time as an instrument for the cognition of this matter. Gradually it adjusts itself to its function, tries to overcome its limitations, creates ever new scientific methods, imagines ever more complex and exact instruments, checks its work again and yet again, step by step penetrates into previously unknown depths, changes our conception of matter without, though ever, breaking away from this basis of all that exists. The true method of knowledge is experiment.
Neuroscience.
Physiological history. Volunteer suffered a blood clot during infancy, which resulted in a left hemisphere stroke. Expected result. In normal adults, the left hemisphere is used for language and other cognitive functions. Extensive damage to this part of the brain usually results in severe cognitive deficiencies. Observed result. Volunteer is now 17 years old and displays only very subtle cognitive deficiency. MRIs indicate little to no activity in the left hemisphere, suggesting its usual functions have been taken on by neuron sets in the right. Volunteer's age at the time of the stroke may have helped the brain to adapt. Interesting. So that was some very shower thoughtsy stuff.
Yeah.
The brain is the only organ that can tell you it is an important organ.
Yeah. I think I remember this. There's a phrase by Carl Sagan that took me a really long time to understand. That we are a way for the universe to understand itself.
Mm-hmm. Because we are made of the universe.
Yeah.
And
we are all made of star stuff.
We are all made of Starsky.
And Hutch.
Hutch is also made of Starsky.
Alright. We got our fifth star.
You can also see kind of like... you can see a lot of the scaling stuff here.
Yeah.
It's sort of the limits of the skybox.
Mm-hmm.
It looks cool. A lot less grand when it doesn't have a lot of stuff obstructing it.
Right. It still looks pretty good, though.
Yeah, definitely not bad.
This is a pretty game.
Yeah. Very well optimized.
A-plus game.
A-plus.
Could develop. The voice keeps saying that this world is a garden, but all I see is a desert full of ruins. Also, I like that that's placed so that the carving is holding it up.
Yeah.
It's interesting.
Never noticed that before. So there's also a fan here. I'm guessing that's tied to the fan blade that we can detach.
Right.
And again, I'm not sure what you do with that. I'm not sure how you get here.
All right. All right.
So.
Cool.
Yeah.
Good talk.
A plus.
I'm disappointed. How dare you show us a secret that you did not manage to get?
It's almost like some things in life are unattainable, no matter how hard you try.
Yes. Give up. That is the only truth.
Just give thanks, up. Thanks, guys. Solid supporters.
Everything is futile.
That's a good note to end this one on. Yeah. All right. So, that will that'll do us for Talos 10.
Yeah.
Everything sucks, give up.
Everything sucks, give up.
You are a
about,
person.
Something about Revolver Ocelot.
All right. Well, yeah. 11 seconds left. What should we do with it? Shit. Decide. We're wasting time. It's almost over.
Pretty good.
Yeah, there we go. Got everything. Good night, internet. Time's over.
Good night, internet.
All right.